Empty box. Tonight we're going to discuss two types of hose protection. One's a sleeve that slides over the entire hose. The other one is actually a wrap that wraps around the hose. The sleeve will also protect the hose, but it also protects operators and machinery from hose bursts and oil jets. So the sleeve is designed to fit over a hose, like this assembly here. This will contain the oil. It won't keep the oil in if there's a burst, but it will reduce the velocity and jets, you know, and just let the oil ooze out through the weave. The other product is what's called a hose wrap. It's a much harder product. It's more for hose protection and abrasion protection for a hose. It won't actually protect operators and machinery from hose bursts, but it gives the hose a longer life and a lot of abrasion resistance. It also makes the hose a lot slipperier. Yeah, it's got a harder coating and it allows things to actually slide over things a lot better. So we'll show you how these are fitted onto the hose, and we'll describe the tricks and techniques to get these to fit nicely and properly onto the hoses. Moving on down here, so we've selected the right size of sleeve that will fit over the hose fittings. If you go too big, it causes creasing when you try and crimp. If you go too small, it just causes difficulty in actually pushing it on. So these are aluminium shells that will actually crimp or will squeeze onto the each end of the hose fitting to hold this sleeve in place. Now, what's its main purpose? Main purpose is, if for some reason this hose fails under high pressure, instead of a jet squirting out and either hitting someone in the face, or if someone's hand is close by or someone's arm's close by, under pressure it will actually penetrate the skin. And once it penetrates into the skin and into the body, you then need surgery. Yeah, you need to go to the hospital and they'll actually cut you open, and they will leave it open for a few hours with some special absorbent pads. They will then close it up, leave it for 24 hours, and then come back 24 hours later, cut it back open again, and then check again if there's any oil still left in it. It's really, really dangerous. Yeah. So what's this meant to do? It's pretty much mandatory on most construction sites now and most mining sites in Australia. What it basically does is suppresses the injection. So instead of this, you know, being a very high pressure, high velocity jet, it will fill this whole bag, if you like, with oil, and then it'll just weep out rather than shoot out under high velocity. So anyway, let's assemble one. This product's made from high density polyethylene, yeah. Great abrasion resistance, UV resistance, also has MHSA certification, which is Mine Safety Health Association certification. Anyway, let's make a piece, let's cut a piece, and we'll show you some of the tricks and tips to do this right. So we're preparing some textile sleeve for a hose. Once we've cut the hose, we need to actually stop the ends from fraying, so we just burn it a little bit to melt the weave so it doesn't continue to fray. We've got these aluminium
tubes or sleeves, as we call them, or ferrules, aluminium ferrules, you know, that we specifically had sized to fit nice and neatly over the hose fitting and the hose sleeve. So what I'm doing now is slowly lining up one end and sliding the sleeves on. They can be a bit tight to get on. The issue is you've got to allow a little bit of slack in the sleeve for when the hose actually bends. So what I'm feeling for now is where the actual hose fitting finishes and the thread starts, and then I'll actually cut it to give me some room. Shells, we line up the shells over the sleeve so it's nice and tidy, and then we crimp the shell onto the sleeve quite firmly, so it actually is quite a tight, neat assembly. We do the same with the other end. What I'm trying to show here is that as you bend the hose, the sleeve actually shortens and pulls back. So we need to allow for that pull back when the hose is bending. That's why when the hose is straight, the sleeve looks a bit wrinkly on the hose. You can see it's a bit fiddly and I'm a bit fussy, so I'm continuously trimming and stuffing around. But things need to look good if people are paying for stuff. So that's it. That's one hose assembly done. This will prevent jets and sprays, and will convert jets and sprays into just an ooze through the weave. Another form of hose protection is a nylon wrap or spiral safety guard. Some people even call it pig's tail. It's a product. Empty box. So it's made in different sizes. This hose outside diameter is 22 millimeters. Let's have a quick look at the 25. I think it might be too big. No, 25 will work. So this product is manufactured from extruded polyethylene material. Good for temperatures from minus 40 up to 138 degrees. Yep. Glycol resistant, oil resistant, and even phosphate ester resistant. So the biggest issue you have with this product is wrapping it onto the hose and estimating the length you need without wasting the length. On a short piece of hose like this, you could probably start at one end and then just actually use what's required. But on longer lengths, where it becomes a little more unwieldy and unmanageable, you've got to actually cut this product, because this comes in 20 meter lengths, and manhandling a 20 meter length of this product around, say, a 3 meter length of hose is not much fun. So we've found, as a general rule, that if you measure the hose length and then multiply it by 1.2, you can then work out quite accurately, we found, how much of this wrap you're going to need. Yeah. So if we look at this hose length here, this hose length is about 54 centimeters. So 54 centimeters times 1.2. What's 54 times 1.2, Dylan?
Do the math.
So about 65 centimeters. So let's cut this at 65 centimeters and see what it looks like. Just give me that yellow pin snips there.
So there's about 65 centimetres.
So that's free length.
All right, because this product will actually stretch and carry on. So,
it's quite difficult to start right at the beginning, so the best place to start is
back 100 or so millimeters from the end, or 4 inches back from the end. You just rotate it on. If it's too long, you can actually wind it down. And then you it's like a spring, really. So you have minimal wastage, and you've got a nice So the beauty of this product is it provides additional protection to the hose, but it also makes it extremely slippery. So rubbing on other hoses, rubbing on other hoses wrapped in this product, there's a lot less friction and a lot less wear. So again, available in many sizes depending on the hose length.